Hello again. This is Gab. This episode is the second in a four-part series about Samsung Gear 2 file transfer. If you haven't watched our previous video, I suggest you watch that first. Last time, we discussed the service part of our application. Today, we'll be discussing the activity part. Now let's begin. If you open the XML layout part, you will see that there is a progress bar. We will be using this as the UI that will inform the user of the current progress of the transfer. Now let's look at the main activity. Tag variable will be used for logging purposes, and the destination path will be used to locate where we will put the file transferred from the wearable. Let's check out the show quit dialog method. Here, the show quit dialog method shows an alert dialog for file transfer, with the negative button to cancel the file transfer. Moving on, let's look into the get file action method. We see here on error, it allows us to dismiss an alert dialog for transfer and shows a toast saying transfer canceled plus an error message. On the on progress method, it allows us to update the UI progress bar by setting its progress. The onTransferComplete method notifies the transfer, resets the progress to zero, dismisses the transfer alert dialog, and provides a toast saying receive completed. The onTransferRequested method is called by the wearable and runs on a UI thread. It shows an alert box to notify if the file transfer has been received. It has two interactive buttons, the positive button to accept the file by calling FT service receive file, and the negative button to reject the file. The main difference between these two buttons are the Boolean values provided a true and false flag. Now let's scroll up and find the instance of the service connection class that we initialized. Basically, these are just listeners for the onServiceConnected and onServiceDisconnected methods. On the onServiceDisconnected method, it allows us to set our mftService object to null. The onServiceConnected is called when a connection to the service has been established. Now let's scroll down a bit. Here we can see an if statement that checks if storage space is available. If no storage space is detected, the application simply finishes. Else, if storage space is available, then we create a directory. And we're almost done. Oh wait, let's check out the manifest file and the metadata file. So here, we should never forget the details, since this allows us to communicate with the Tizen end. And our manifest file. As seen below. And that's about it. Let's have a recap of this episode. We have to remember that logging is important. Always manage your communication channel, and declare your metadata in the manifest file. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Stay tuned for the part 3 of the series. Thanks for watching.